closely monitored after traveling aboard Air Force One on Friday with a staff member who has since tested positive for the coronavirus. Capitol Hill today, lots of finger pointing after West Virginia Democratic Senator Joe Manchin effectively ended plans to pass President Biden's nearly $2 trillion Build Back Better bill by the end of the year. Manchin would not say today why the talks failed, but when pressed, he partially blamed White House staff.
And it's staff driven. I understand staff. It's not the president, it's the staff. And they drove some things and they put some things out that were absolutely inexcusable. And they know what it is, and that's it.
Manchin speaking today to the West Virginia Metro News Radio Network.
So you're personally offended and you want to cancel everyone's benefits?
Retaining control of the House, Florida Congresswoman Stephanie Murphy says she will not run for re-election next year. And
but you should have removed some Republican senators for treason, Trumpy treason.
She became the first Vietnamese American woman to serve in Congress. She also was
the first vote
woman of color to lead the Blue Dog Coalition, a group of centrist Democrats in the House. In announcing her decision not to run again, she touted her record working across the aisle under both Republican and Democratic presidents. It gave some advice to colleagues at a divisive time in politics.
To stop the name-calling, saber-rattling, and the disinformation, and to listen to one another. Be ideological in the fight, but pragmatic in the end.
Stephanie Murphy was one of the top targets of Republicans working to retake control of the House in 2022. More than 20 Democrats have decided to retire or run for another political office. Deirdre Walsh, NPR News.
This is
not progressive enough.
This is CPR News. I'm Amy Sanchez.
Trump
light. A report shows labor demand in Colorado has recovered at a rapid pace, but the people looking for jobs don't have the necessary skills. CPR's Jenny Brundine has more.
The state hopes to bridge the talent gap through apprenticeships and other reskill or upskill programs. Workforce development analyst Caitlin McKenney says most top jobs still require a four-year degree, but there's a new trend.
We're also seeing an increased demand for individuals with shorter term, non-degree credentials across top jobs.
Especially in healthcare and technical jobs. Demand is strong for behavioral health counselors, teachers, healthcare
people.
Workers,
we better just have free education, free
drivers.
College for everybody.
More information on scholarships for the skills programs can be found at my